and you can get the best internet and phone services for half of what you're paying today. Cutting costs can be easy when you get Spectrum Business. Just call 888-489-2212. Restrictions apply. Call for details.
Need a new water heater? Water Heaters Only, with over 53 years in business, offers low prices, quality same-day service, and for a limited time, monthly payments as low as $89 for a water heater replacement. Visit waterheatersonly.com. Terms and conditions apply.
In the warehouse, the job has to get done. But if you're working with an outdated forklift that has more downtime than up due to maintenance, it's time to make the switch to Nobelift lithium-ion-powered forklifts. With a Nobelift forklift, you get less downtime, a longer lifespan, fast, efficient opportunity charging, and a five-year cost of ownership that will save you almost $45,000 over internal combustion models. Nobelift, revolutionizing the material handling industry one job at a time. What's in your warehouse? Contact us today for a cost analysis at nobeliftna.com/save.
Have you wanted to speak a new language but thought it'd be too difficult or take too much time? Then try Babbel. In just 15 minutes a day, Babbel teaches you conversations that you will actually use. With 14 languages and lesson topics like travel, business, relationships, and more, you'll learn what matters most to you. Babbel. Language for life. Learn a new language with ease. Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's Babbel.com.
Hey, it's John and Ken from KFI AM 640. If you haven't downloaded the free iHeartRadio app yet, now's the perfect time. Because for the first time ever, all free users can create unlimited playlists.
iHeartRadio makes it super easy to create playlists for any mood or occasion. And here's one way to get started. Just grab a song playing on your favorite station and start a playlist with that. Easiest of all, it's totally free.
Add as many songs, create as many playlists, all for free.
Number one for music, radio, and podcasts all in one app, iHeartRadio. Oh, we almost came over your house yesterday, about a half mile away, and I realized we were near your house, and so we had a meeting whether to go, and I voted no,
because I said you probably wouldn't open the door.
And I have the Ring doorbell, so
that's right,
be there.
If you would see us.
John and Ken, weekdays at 2.
Well, you know, they said, well, why would he not answer the door? I said, because he doesn't want to see us.
On KFI.
Welcome to a Thursday. I see the weekend right around the corner. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee, and some of the stories we're watching in the KFI 24-hour newsroom. U.S. Marshals have arrested a man with multiple weapons who was trying to enter the Roybal Federal Building in downtown L.A. The man was stopped yesterday morning as he tried to drive his pickup into a parking garage off Alameda Street. Contract security officers noticed a gun in the cab and detained the man. Sources told KFI News the man was wearing body armor, was posing as a federal agent. It's not clear the man's motive, but during a search of the truck, agents found two rifles, a handgun, multiple loaded magazines, and combat medical supplies. And Johnson & Johnson is recalling 5 sunscreen products because of a chemical found in them that can cause cancer. The company says benzene was found after internal testing and testing by an outside lab. Johnson & Johnson says it's investigating how the chemical got into the products. The recall includes 1 Aveeno sunscreen and 4 Neutrogena sunscreens. Right now, it's your chance to win $1,000.
KFI has your chance to win $1,000.
Text the nationwide keyword
BANK, B-A-N-K,
to 200-200.
You'll get a confirmation text and info.
Standard data and message rates apply in this nationwide contest.
That's BANK to 200-200.
And you know the drill. If you get a call from a number you don't recognize, please pick it up because I want you to win the money. Because if you don't pick it up when they call, they move on to somebody who will. And your next chance to win comes at 7:20 during Handle on the News with Wayne. Right now, let's say good morning to ABC's Jim Ryan. Jim, where are all these lawmakers this morning who left Texas? I assume they're still in D.C. And who is paying for this trip?
Yes, they are in Washington, and that depends upon who's being asked. Governor Abbott says that it's a taxpayer-funded junket. The Democrats say that's not the case, that their own campaigns, the Democratic Party, and other donors have paid for their plane fare and hotels while they're in Washington, food and expenses. So they say it's funded internally. The governor says that it's a state-funded kind of function, but suffice it to say that holding a special session costs the state about $1.3 million in the first place, and the legislature is sitting down there idle because there's no quorum present to vote on pretty much anything, Jen.
Have those Democrats said when they're coming back?
Well, yes. This current special session is supposed to end on August 7th. That's the deadline. It's a 30-day session. And they'll come back on August 8th. The governor says that, fine, he'll just hold another special session and another one after that. There was to be a special session in the fall anyway to tackle redistricting matters. He may decide to hold off until then and just roll it all into one thing. The debate, of course, is over new election restrictions that Republicans want to put into place here in Texas.
And how much did you say that this special election cost this time around?
It's about $1.3 million for each special session. I mean, that's keeping the lights on at the state house and keeping staff paid and security and all the rest of it. About $1.3 million.
So in a way, his argument that it's state-funded is kind of right in the sense of until they come back, we have to keep doing this again, and that does cost the state money.
Yeah, right. So in other words, both sides are right. Yeah, the Democrats say their trips were funded by their own campaigns and by a Democratic loyalist. That's true. And yet, yes, the legislature has to keep running, and that costs money, too.
Okay, so when they do eventually come back, because at some point somebody's going to have to come back, somebody's going to be there when this special election happens, because the governor seems, you know, completely hell-bent on making sure that it does happen. So if that's the case, this then just becomes largely symbolic, because it sounds like the outcome is inevitable once the quorum is reached.
Yeah, I think you're right. And that's what happened in 2003. A similar thing was happening over a redistricting package that the Republicans were pushing. Some Democrats went up, 51 of them at that time, went up over the state line into Oklahoma and stayed up there. Members of the state Senate, Democrats in the state Senate, went over to Albuquerque, New Mexico. So they were just outside the reach of the Texas troopers. Eventually, one member of the Senate decided to break. He went back down to Austin. Therefore, the Republicans had a quorum. They voted and they passed that redistricting bill.
Okay, and are they going to be arrested?
Well, yeah. I mean, arrested is usually in a loose term, because they aren't committing a criminal offense. They're committing a civil offense under state law. So they would not be taken into custody, even if they come back into Texas and taken to jail. They would be taken to the state capitol and would literally be locked into the chambers there and then forced to vote on different matters. That's what's happening right now. In fact, the people who are still in Austin at the capitol are literally locked in. In the House, for example, the Speaker of the House has to give them permission to leave, even to walk up and use the restroom. So at some point, I mean, it's a technical thing, and it's written in the state constitution, but at some point it gets kind of silly.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, Jim, I don't know what's going on there in Texas, but y'all are putting on a show.
Thank you.
Have a great one.
See you later.
See you later. ABC's Jim Ryan. Wow. I don't know. I guess everything really is bigger in Texas. Even the show that their lawmakers put on. You thought our folks in California were good. Come on now. Ain't got nothing on Texas right now. All right. Speaking of y'all, Alex and John, I asked them to join me on this next little segment here. They don't even know what I'm talking about. Dictionary.com has added some new words. Okay. Guys, you there?
Yeah.
Okay. So I know most of these. Culture appropriation, long hauler, 5G, ghost gun. Those are some of the new words at dictionary.com. But I thought that these three specifically were good. And I thought, well, why hasn't this one been added? Y'all. Okay, so I think we all say y'all, correct?
Yeah, all day, every day.
Okay. And as my very southern husband has taught me, y'all can be singular or plural. What are y'all doing today? Could be both of you, or just you, Alex, or just you, John.
Okay, I have an issue with that, but I'll let it slide.
Okay, you know, whatever. Okay.
I think it's plural, but you know, I'll let Scott slide on this one.
Okay, well that's what I figure. You know, when the Southerner tells me that it's one way or whatever, all right. What do I know? Okay. What is yeet?
Oh yeah, I'm so happy dictionary.com to include this.
Yeet.
Alex, can I take this one?
What is yeet?
Yeet, it's basically like to toss, to throw, like with it in a very like aggressive sort of fashion.
Use it in a sentence.
John, your turn.
Okay. I yeeted out of the store after I got my, I don't know, pair of socks. Like I got out of there real quick.
Yeeted out of the store.
Yeah,
okay.
I yeeted it across the room.
That's a good one. I yeeted across the room, meaning like I just ran across the room.
Went there
know?
Quick. Okay.
Yeah, like got, you know.
And zaddy.
Zaddy?
Zaddy.
I've heard that, but I don't know what it means. Is it Generation Z Daddy?
I think so. I think
I'm
Zaddy.
I'm guessing Zaddy, yeah?
Yeah, I would say... It's basically, when we can think, you know, I mean, the interwebs are thinking, you know, Thai dollar sign for it. It's kind of like an attractive man who's stylish, charming, self-confident.
No, it's an older one, though. It also specifically an older gentleman that's fashionable and attractive.
Oh.
Like, he knows how to handle business, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he's a zaddy.
Yes.
Okay, all right.
That,
Please don't say that again.
Please don't.
Okay, and finally, how about this one? I have heard both of you use this one. There is a new definition for the word snack.
Oh! Yes!
I didn't realize John and I work for dictionary.com.
Yes!
You really do. All right, snack is not just like a snack. When I say snack, there are three dogs listening at home right now who have just run to the corner of the kitchen because they think they're getting a treat. Not the case anymore, right, guys?
Not even close. So it's basically, I mean, you've heard like, man, I mean, again, this is not sounding bad, but it's like using a sentence like, wow, it's like, look at that snack over there. He looks really good. Or, hey, she looks really good. Like, you know, you're kind of like, dang, like, wow, that person looks really nice. Like,
yeah.
Someone looks good in the moment, right? That's really what the basis of what a snack means. Like, yeah.
Which is funny because I have older friends who, I'm going to say in their 60s and 70s, who will say things like, you are so cute, I could just eat you up. They could save a whole bunch of words if they just said, you're a snack.
Exactly.
Yep. It all comes full circle. Thank you guys for letting me ambush you.
This is great. I'm a huge fan of dictionary.com.
I'm a big fan. Huge fan.
I'm going to yeet across the room and get me one.
Oh,
and then call my zaddy and ask him what y'all doing today.
Nope.
Oh, and we're done.
Okay. When we come back, let's talk with ABC's crime and terrorism analyst, Brad Garrett. We've talked before about the increase in the number of unruly passengers on the plane. Maybe the zaddy or the snack next to you. I don't know. But
stop, please.
I was trying to use it in a sentence. Last week, it was the National Spelling Bee. Leave me alone. But this past week, the FAA saw its largest increase in the number of unruly passengers. So what is behind all this air rage? We'll talk with Brad in just a few minutes. And we've got this very cool feature piece from KFI's Steve Gregory on the way. The LA County Sheriff's Department has sworn in its youngest deputy. All that's coming up. Nick, be honest. How many of those words did you know the definition of?
I just have to tell you, I was laughing so hard listening to the three of you talk of it. And I too, like the kids, granted, I'm a little bit older than them. But, yeah, I know all of them, and I use y'all all the time. It's a really good group pronoun that has no gender, so that works really, really well. So y'all is very important. No. We're in a very unique time period in the world right now, and so, yeah, I use y'all regularly.
I
always have, but anyway,
that.
Yeah. No, it's an easy way. If you're worried about, in any way, shape, or form, about anybody being concerned about that, y'all works beautifully because it has no gender attached.
All right, well, I'm using that one now all the time.
You have my permission,
all right,
completely.
Thank you. Now on the 91 again.
It's a crash this go-around in the Anaheim Hills area, westbound sign of the 4 Imperial. Thanks for the heads up from Ricky Menez on the KFI traffic tip line, pound 250 on your cell phone. Keyword is KFI traffic. Really slow going for the drive on the westbound 91 from Weir Canyon or Yorba-Linda Boulevard. You make way past Imperial to that wreck. Even before that, though, it's going to be slow going for your drive on the westbound side of the 91 from as far back as La Sierra as you get out of the Riverside area, and also starting to see some delays on the 5 northbound this go-around. Out of Norwalk, leaving the 605, that would be patchy for your drive all the way through Boyle Heights towards downtown LA and the 101. KFI in the sky helps get to there faster. I'm Nick Pagliocchini. Dean Sharp here. Nothing disrupts your life, your comfort, even your safety like a power outage, and outages are the new normal. So now is the time to set up your home with an emergency generator from Duffy Power. Duffy is Southern California's generator experts, and with 0% interest financing, emergency power totally affordable. Duffy Power, making sure your life, your comfort, and your safety are not to be interrupted. Dial pound 250 on your cell and say Duffy Power. Pound 250 Duffy Power, or on the web at DuffyPower.com.
SoCal weather from KFI. Sunny today with highs in the 70s at the beaches, 80s for Metro LA and OC, 90s for the valleys and the IE. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee.
There are no limits to what we can do together. So let's keep rising, California.
Esquina, esquina, ya nos vamos. El mundo es grande, pero lo tengo en mis manos. Estoy muy duro, sí, okay, vamos. Si con el tiempo no seguimos elevando.
Get vaccinated and wear a mask when it can protect you and others. Your actions save lives. To learn more, visit covid19.ca.gov.
Subject to change without notice. Minimum loan amount requirements apply. 60% loan to value and 620 FICO credit score. Certain restrictions apply. Subject to credit approval. NMLS 3290. Loans made or arranged pursuant to a California Finance Lenders Law License number 6036970. Equal housing lender.
5:35 in the morning. It is time for you to wake up. Okay, maybe you don't have to get out of bed right now, but what I do want you to start thinking about is all these great home loan rates that you've heard being advertised. Here's the question. So why haven't you applied? Maybe you've thought, nah, I'm not going to qualify. Maybe I'm self-employed or my credit is just meh. Whatever your reason is, I think you should call my friends at IntelliLoan and ask them anyway. Because right now, IntelliLoan is offering a 1.99% APR with no points or lender fees. And look, this is even if your credit score is a 620. So now no more excuses. If you are self-employed or you just have okay credit, whatever your situation is, IntelliLoan can help you get that great home loan that you've been looking for. Right now it's a 1.99% APR with no points or lender fees that they're offering. And this is even if your credit score is a 620. So what are you waiting for? Call IntelliLoan before the rates go up. Call them at 1-800-918-6200. That's 1-800-918-6200. Or just go to IntelliLoan.com.
IntelliLoan. Borrow smart.
Hey, it's Dean Sharp. If you've decided to sell your house, I know it is tempting to just get it listed as is or even take one of those cash out deals. But why sell yourself short when making just the right upgrades will maximize its sale value?
You mean like flipping our own home, Dean? We don't have the expertise or the cash for that.
I know, but my friends at Revive do. Revive knows exactly what to change, what to spend, and where to spend it. They'll manage everything for you and front all the costs. Yes, Revive fronts the cost. They get paid back from escrow, but the profit gained is all yours. How much profit? The average client makes over 200% profit on what Revive invests on their behalf. It's a no-brainer. Reach out to iloverevive.com today and see if your home qualifies. To make the most from the sale of your home, go to iloverevive.com. That's iloverevive.com.
Shift hiring gears with Indeed. They go beyond the resume with 135 skills tests that help candidates show their abilities on things like computer proficiency or customer service. Indeed skills tests reduce hiring time by 27% on average. Visit Indeed.com/credit.
If you're tired of struggling with business, mortgage, or credit card debt, go to OaktreeLaw.com. That's OaktreeLaw.com.
Live,
KFI,
local,
AM 640,
an iHeart radio station. KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeart radio app. Welcome to a Thursday morning. I'm glad you're here. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee, and some of the stories we're watching in the KFI 24-hour newsroom. Britney Spears has been freed from her court-appointed legal team. She's been represented by a court-appointed lawyer since 2008. Her new lawyer is a former federal prosecutor and Hollywood attorney, Matthew Rosengard. And the Duckweiler and El Segundo beaches have reopened to swimmers following a closure because of a sewage spill last week. 5:55, we'll talk more about Netflix and a new venture. They've hired someone from Facebook to help them with this new venture. I'll tell you what it is. And how in the world is a toy that cost $25, and I'm not meaning $25 50 years ago, $25 recently, is now priced at $28,000. All those stories coming up in your Biz Bites in just a few minutes. Right now, let's say good morning to ABC's crime and terrorism analyst, Brad Garrett. Hey, Brad, good morning. So recently we've been talking about the number of unruly passengers that we've heard from the FAA. Flight attendants have been saying this is out of control. But just the past week, the FAA said it saw its largest increase in the number of unruly passengers. What's wrong with us these days?
Well, if you look at this since January, over 3,000 people have been either they're not wearing masks, they get in arguments with the flight attendants or fellow passengers, flight attendants have been injured, You know, if you look as to what is the motivation here, it seems, Jennifer, that it's driven by people just feel entitled to act this way. You know, is that driven, for example, like in one study said that roughly 40% of the people believe that COVID is not worse than the flu, 25% think the pandemic's a hoax. I mean, we've heard these numbers before, but the reason I'm bringing them up is that I think this drives some of this behavior. It's like, you know, the government's given us false information. The media, if it's not some media outlet I like, it's giving me wrong information. So they just want to believe what they believe and then feel entitled to act, you know, in a way that's clearly irresponsible. You know, you can believe whatever you want to believe about President Trump and his thoughts and ideas about COVID and other things. But when it comes to responsibility of your fellow man, that has to, you know, weigh heavier, whether you believe it or not. This is a serious disease, and it's killed millions of people worldwide. But there's just a lot of people that just don't get that.
You know, I started thinking about what the difference is when a flight attendant tells you, don't smoke in the bathroom. And for some reason, most of us abide by that. We know that there could be a big fine attached to it. Should we do that? But the wearing of the mask, the flight attendant tells you not to do that, and you feel entitled. I guess that's where my brain says, what is it that makes those two things so different? It's both are things that you are told by the airline not to do. So why do we abide by one and maybe not by the other?
Because the smoking is not so politically charged. The mask is politically charged because you have, you know, portions of folks that used to be in the government. You clearly have a number of media outlets that stoke the fire every day about that the government's giving you misinformation, that this disease really isn't as bad as they say that it is, that it's really not that contagious. I mean, they go on and on. And so they sort of weaponize, in my view, that, you know, false information. And if you're a person that already has sort of iffy thoughts about the legitimacy or trusting, let's say, the federal government, this just adds fuel to that. And if that's all you listen to or read about in a given day, if you're so inclined to think that way, it'll just drive you right over the edge. So, I mean, I don't find, Jennifer, this behavior on planes much different than I do from a thinking standpoint than the people who attacked the Capitol on January 6th. They felt entitled to do it. They felt it was the right thing to do for, you know, a sundry of reasons. And so it's this whole mindset that's the issue at hand.
When it comes to, I was fascinated by, there was a line that I read about you last night that said you have your own experience pulling unruly passengers off planes while you were in the FBI. Were those situations where these people seemed to feel entitled to do whatever it was they were doing that caused them to get in trouble in the first place?
Well, maybe, but most of the folks I dealt with, it was driven by alcohol.
Okay.
And particularly on longer flights where people, you know, had too much to drink. They got abusive to passengers. They got, you know, abusive to flight attendants. We pulled them off. I'd take them to jail. And a number of them got prosecuted, and some of them actually were sent to prison. And if they weren't from the U.S., they were banned from coming in the U.S. for a period of time. So it's always been a little bit of a problem, but now, because of the divisiveness that goes on, and, you know, and the other thing, besides people not, or a certain percentage of people, Jennifer, not trusting the government, they also don't trust their fellow Americans unless they believe what they believe. It's almost like they think one way, and if you're either on this bandwagon or you're not, and I'm just not going to believe you. And we've now got a large chunk, I think several million people, that think some version of that every day. And that's why these numbers are going up, and I don't expect to see them going down.
I hate to hear that, but I'm with you on that one. All right, Brad, thank you so much for analyzing it all. I appreciate it.
No problem. Take care, Jennifer.
Hey, thanks. You too. See you later. ABC's crime and terrorism analyst, Brad Garrett. I think he's right. I completely agree. I don't see this getting any better anytime soon. Is it going to come down to a larger crackdown? Is it going to come down to, oh, we're not taking this plane off the ground, or we're turning this plane around if you don't comply with orders? And the other thing is, can we all just remember this? It is such a pain in the tush to go through security and get on the plane in the first place. And if you're Southwest, it's a freaking cattle call and the whole nine yards. And it's enough. We just want to get on the plane, get to where we're going, and get off the plane. How much has it peeved you off before that the guy in front of you, for whatever reason, is arguing with the flight attendant about something and you can't get off the ground in time? And you're thinking to yourself, dude, just shut your pie hole. Is this really the hill you want to die on? Whatever it happens to be. And then everybody else on the plane gets mad at the guy. And is it really worth it? Just think to yourself, is it really worth it? At the end of the day, do you not want to get to your destination because you really had a problem with the flight attendant telling you, please put your mask back on? At the end of the day, is it that big of a deal? All right, let's get back to some of these stories coming out of the KFI 24-hour newsroom. The LA County Sheriff's Department has sworn in its youngest deputy.
He's 1.5 years old, and his name is Satoshi, a black Labrador retriever.
And he is trained to alert on electronic devices.
Sergeant Pete Hitch is with the Department's Cyber Crimes Bureau and says Satoshi goes by Tosh for short.
He's an electronic sniffer. He is very particular in the types of electronic he can sniff. The electronics have to have some sort of a storage capacity to them, like a flash drive, a cell phone, a hard drive, laptop, things of that nature.
Ish says Tosh is the first of its kind for the department. He's an actual canine with the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department.
Yes, sir. Actually, he was just sworn in by the sheriff. He has a badge and ID card, and he is a deputy sheriff here on our department.
So you got to explain this. So he's able to go in and sniff a computer hard drive and tell us what?
Tell us that there is an electronic storage device there, is what he tells us. He can't tell us what's on it, obviously. We don't even know what's on it, but he can tell us that right here in this area, in this box, in this pile of clothes, under this rock, in this sprinkler head, wherever, that there is an electronic storage device there. And that gives the investigators the ability to further look into that area and find the devices that may be hidden.
Hish says Satoshi was donated by Operation Underground Railroad, a nonprofit aimed at stopping child exploitation. The Black Lab's ongoing expenses are covered by a state grant. Hish says there's meaning behind the name Satoshi.
We wanted to give him some sort of a cyber name, an electronics name, so we figured, hey, Bitcoin has a name within Bitcoin called Satoshi. A Satoshi is a fraction of a Bitcoin. So we figured that would be a good name for him, and we called him that. He actually can find Bitcoin hardware wallets. So during an investigation, some kind of a fraud investigation or some kind of extortion or something where Bitcoin was used, he can actually go to the location on a search warrant and locate these wallets that contain Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies.
Bitcoin sniff dog.
Yeah, you could call him that. He can sniff out Bitcoin as long as it's on a hardware wallet, yeah.
So how would Satoshi do with a radio reporter's gear bag filled with recording devices and other electronics? Okay, so I gotta get to know this guy a little bit.
Sure.
Come here, buddy. Come here, boy. Okay, let's stop for a moment. For the next few seconds, me and Sergeant Hish, as grown men, cannot be held responsible for the way we're gonna talk to the dog, okay?
Let's put the microphone out too, since you're recording there. You're recording.
Yeah, I noticed that.
There. Yeah.
And then, because you figure I got 3 or 4 different hard drive devices in there.
Yeah. We'll do it. I'll show you real quick how he alerts us quick. So, okay. You have stuff in there?
Yeah, he should, yeah.
So, come here, let's go to work, buddy. Come on, let's go to work. Let's go to work. Come on, see him sit? You're telling me it's there? Show me. Yes, good boy.
So he's able to snip out that I had little hard drives. Okay, back to Sirius. He says Tosh is going to be busy and has already helped the federal agency with a case and will be at it all week. Like other canine units, does he stay with you 24/7?
Yes, he has a great life. He is with us here at the office all day long. He knows the crew here. He gets along with them. They take him for walks. They play with him. He goes home with me at the end of the day. He hooks up with my other dog. The first thing he does when he gets home is goes in the backyard, hooks up with my other dog, and they're in the pool.
All in a day's work. At Sheriff's Headquarters, Steve Gregory, KFI News.
And it is so much fun if you go to Steve's Instagram, Steve Gregory, at Steve, I think it's at Steve Gregory, yeah, at Steve Gregory 640 on Instagram. You can see this video of Steve, and you can see the handler of Satoshi take the dog over to Steve's bag. And man, that dog sniffs and boom, it sits down. It is great fun. And Satoshi, you are a handsome little devil. I'm telling you. Anyways, at Steve Gregory 640 on Instagram. So much fun. All right, we come back. I'll tell you why Netflix has a new venture and has hired someone from Facebook to help. And there was a toy that used to cost $25. It's now $28,000. No, not because it's some toy that got lost 50-some years ago or something like that. It just now costs $28,000, and it used to cost $25 not long ago. I'll tell you why. Right now, let's take a look at your drive, and Nick can tell us why. We've got the 91 again a problem. This is ridiculous.
Yeah, you're telling me. It's a big problem for your drive in Anaheim Hills, westbound side of the 91 past Imperial. It's a big rig wreck, and the sedan got stuck under a big rig. The two right lanes are shut down. Your immediate slowing is going to be coming away from the 241 toll road. Overall, 91 westbound going to be heavy stretches of slowing for you out of Riverside from as far back as Tyler. So definitely give yourself plenty of time getting out the door this morning. Orange County still pretty quiet for your drive. Not seeing anything major going down for your drive, although getting into Orange County, 57 southbound out of Pomona leaving Temple, patchy delays for you through the Brea Canyon getting into the Brea area. As you make way westbound along the 105 through Linwood, coming off the 710, going to be patchy for your drive in stretches through Crenshaw Boulevard. Further westbound on the 105 toward El Segundo, Sepulveda Boulevard, and LAX, not too bad of a drive. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Nick Pagliocchini.
This report is sponsored by Indeed.com. Shift hiring gears with Indeed. They go beyond the resume with 135 skills tests that help candidates show their abilities on things like computer proficiency or customer service. Indeed skills tests reduce hiring time by 27% on average. Visit Indeed.com/credit.
This is Dan Patrick. Here's what's trending on the iHeart Sports Network, presented by Mercedes-AMG.
The NBA Finals are all tied up at 2 games apiece. Late-game heroics by Giannis Antetokounmpo helped the Bucks rally past the Suns in Game 4. Major League Baseball officials are extending Trevor Bauer's administrative leave through July 27th. A woman accused the Dodgers pitcher of sexual assault. Bauer denied the allegations. And USC basketball will spend Thanksgiving on the hardwood. The Trojans will reportedly face St. Joseph's in the Wooden Legacy. I'm Misty Jordan.
Do you suffer from lead foot? Do goosebumps appear for no reason? Stop living with uninspired performance. Visit MBUSA.com/AMG and find out if a Mercedes-AMG coupe, sedan, or SUV is right for you. Mercedes-AMG, driving performance.
Have you ever gone to take out your recycling and noticed that the majority of the things in your recycling bin are plastic water bottles? I have, and I've thought to myself, I don't want to be that guy anymore. That's why I am getting a LifeSource Whole House Water System installed. I've known how great these things are, and when we got our house, I said one of the first things I want to put in is a LifeSource Whole House Water System. We've been there a few months now. We've got the time, we've got the know-how, and I know how to get you one. So you just go to LifeSource, and you can find out how great their systems are. You're going to get clean, delicious water coming out of every faucet in your house. And what I like about it is you get to be lazy about it. They install it, you forget about it. Once you get a LifeSource Whole House Water System, there's no maintenance, no filters to replace, no tanks to exchange. And hey, if you have hard water, a LifeSource Whole House Water System can help with that too. Plus, it's going to reduce the odor and taste of chlorine without using salt or chemicals. And you're going to be bathing in filtered water. So this is going to help your skin and your hair. And you can have LifeSource create a customized water solution for your home. And all the products come directly from the factory where they've been in Southern California for over 37 years. And everything is made in the USA. And if you're looking for a great new career opportunity, LifeSource is looking for you. So call LifeSource today, just like I did, and get full service and full confidence in your water. Call them at 1-800-334-5009. That's 1-800-334-5009. Or just visit LifeSourceWater.com. LifeSource Water. Taste and feel the difference.
The most important financial decision you'll make isn't picking the next hot stock or fund manager. It's selecting the right financial advisor. How do you pick the advisor that's right for you? Find out in a special virtual event with New York Times bestselling author Rick Edelman, Tuesday, July 20th at 3 p.m. or at 8 p.m. Eastern. It's free. Register at EdelmanFinancialEngines.com. During the event, you'll get advice on how to select the right financial advisor, and you'll get a list of the 11 must-ask questions you can carry with you when you interview financial advisors. If you already have an advisor, you can use the list to evaluate if they are right for you. The virtual event will give you all the information you need to help you make the right decision, and Rick will make it entertaining. The presentation is free, so register right now for this special virtual event on July 20th at 3 p.m. or at 8 p.m. Eastern. Register at EdelmanFinancialEngines.com. That's EdelmanFinancialEngines.com.
Enjoy a powerful business upgrade with Dell Technologies Black Friday in July event. Get amazing savings with up to 50% off high-performance computers and tech built for business, and be able to take your office with you with Windows 10 Pro. Plus, get great offers on Dell servers, monitors, docks, and more, all with easy financing options through Dell Financial Services. Call 877-ASK-DELL. That's 877-ASK-DELL. And speak to a Dell Technologies advisor today.
Attorney Joe Cordell. For many men, divorce brings a bewildering sense of loss. You feel adrift, isolated, like you're the only person in the world. But the good news is, you're not alone. Cordell & Cordell is here to help. For more than 30 years, Cordell & Cordell has been there to guide men through all aspects of divorce. And we'll be there for you.
Schedule an appointment with one of Cordell & Cordell's California area attorneys. 1455 Frazee Road, Suite 500, San Diego, California, 92108. CordellCordell.com.
Your kitchen sink is clogged, so you call a handyman. He pulls up in an old dented truck, but that's okay, because he's cheap. He cracks mud, or what looks like mud, across your carpet, but that's okay, because he's cheap. He puts his dirty tools on your kitchen counter where you prepare food, but that's okay, because he's cheap. Hello, I'm John O'Quinn, owner of Rooter Hero Plumbing. We can clean that same drain for only $77. And we'll treat your home like it's your castle, because it is. Rooter Hero will clean your drain, treat you like a king or queen, and we'll do it for only $77. That's how we came up with our phone number, 866-DRAIN-77. And here's my promise to you. If Rooter Hero doesn't live up to your expectations, then call me. 866-DRAIN-77. My personal cell phone number is on every business card. You can also reach us at rooterhero.com.
When it comes to keeping you safe, Bay Alarm brings the best. Family owned and celebrating 75 years of professional personal service that's second to none. Bay Alarm, celebrating our past, securing your future.
ACO28CCL880138.
Hi, I'm Miguel Cardona, U.S. Secretary of Education and proud father of two. This summer is so important to help young people reconnect with friends, peers, and educators after such a difficult year. It's time for students to rediscover the joy of learning, brush up on their skills in reading, STEM, athletics, and the arts. There's